Jay here with FCP Euro. Today we're working on this 2004 Volvo S60 2.5T. I'm going to show you how to replace the turbocharger, oil return line seal, and gasket. Let's begin. All right, so the first thing you want to do is support the vehicle. I'm using a lift for demonstration purposes, but you can easily just support it with jack stands and crawl underneath. This is a front wheel drive model, so it's much easier to gain access to the turbo return line seal. If you have an all-wheel drive vehicle, my best suggestion is to remove the angle gear from the vehicle. It's a little bit more work, but it's going to make this process much, much easier for you. All right, first you're going to see there's a bracket here holding the oil feed line to the return line. You're going to want to remove, it's a 10 millimeter nut, just remove that bracket. Now remove the two T30 Torx. And bolt the return line to the turbocharger itself. With a 13 millimeter socket, crack loose the drain cock on the driver's side, lower radiator, and drain the coolant. Now open your expansion tank cap to allow the coolant to drain. Now that the coolant has finished draining, go ahead and tighten up the drain cock. Make sure not to over-tighten, it's a plastic cock. If you over-tighten it, it will break. Now there's two coolant lines on the back of the turbo. There's gonna be a feed line and a return line. You're gonna loosen the lower line that's on the turbo. It's a 17 millimeter bolt. Now pull the line out of your way. You may need the assistance of a pry bar. All right, so now that the pipe has been removed from the car, you can clearly see there's some oil leakage going on here. This gasket was on its way out. So we're gonna replace the top gasket as well as the bottom seal. The seal is still in the vehicle, so make sure that you remove that from the intermediate section. We're gonna go ahead and reseal this and reinstall it in the car now. Just gonna pull the old seal out of the block here. All right, before I install the return line back into the vehicle, I just put on the new seal here, and I'm just gonna take a little bit of silicone grease and lube up that seal so it slides back in nicely and doesn't get held up on anything. You could be liberal with this. One final step before we put the line back into the vehicle, just take some brake clean in a rag or some type of cleaning agent and just make sure that the mating surface for that gasket is clean and free of debris. And same thing for where the seal goes on the block end. Again, a little bit of cleaning agent. I use a microfiber towel. And just go in there and you can twist your finger around. Just make sure you get rid of all any type of debris. Anything that could cause that seal to leak. Now take your line and guide it back into place. Next, I like to take a mirror and a light and just look down that lower seal and make sure it didn't fold over on itself. Make sure it's seated properly. This one appears to be seated nice. So we'll go ahead and next step is to put on the upper gasket. Now take your gasket, slide it into place, and install the bolt. You just take one bolt threaded in and get the second one started. Really quick, before I go ahead and reinstall the banjo bolt for the coolant line, I noticed that there's some corrosion or debris built up in the bottom of the bolt. So I'm just gonna go ahead and try to remove that as best as possible, just so you don't develop any leaks. Now take a little bit of cleaner and clean where the coolant line reattaches to the turbo. Again, just to prevent any leaks. This part could be a little tedious. There's two crush washers on this banjo bolt. One's gonna go on the bolt itself, and the other one's gonna go on the turbo, between the turbo and the coolant line. So let's take our coolant line, put it back up into place.
Take your banjo bolt and kind of just rest it into place. And take your crush washer. You can use some needle nose pliers and you could seat it onto the bolt. Hold some pressure on it. Start threading it in by hand. Make sure it's threaded in, because as soon as you let it go and that line backs out, crush washer will drop. It looks like this one's going in. Now reinstall your bracket. I'm just going to give the area a quick spray down with some brake clean. Now since we removed the coolant from the vehicle, crack open a line, we're going to go ahead and fill it back up. Alright guys, and that's how you replace the turbo return line seal and upper gasket on this 04 Volvo S60. Again, this is the 2.5T front-wheel drive model. If you do have the all-wheel drive model, it's going to be much more difficult to get to. I recommend removing the angle gear at that point. If you have any additional comments or questions, please comment in the box below. And also, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.